hear me? Should have done a mic check. Here we go. Hi, good evening. Welcome to the Minnesota Zoo for the School of Environmental Studies class of 2024 graduation ceremony. My name is Trinity Leiser, and I'm the School Programs and Early Childhood Specialist at the Zoo. While this is my first full school year in this role, I have loved seeing the students on our campus over my 7 years at the Zoo. This past school year, I have thoroughly enjoyed meeting in this same space to kick off the school year last fall, observing some ingenious muscle campaign presentations, and watching the students engage with nature here on Zoo grounds. Because of the conservation-based learning at the School of Environmental Studies, I am filled with hope and inspired by this generation as they go out into the world and continue to protect and conserve wildlife and the places they call home. Tonight, we celebrate a group of young people who have attained the knowledge and skills through their K-12 education journey and embark on a new chapter in their lives. On behalf of all of us here at the Minnesota Zoo, we are proud to have been part of that journey and look forward to seeing what these amazing young people accomplish next. Before we officially begin the ceremony, I do have some very important announcements. First up, restroom location. So if you go up the stairs and to your right, there's also a sign on the side of the stairs here. You will find the restrooms over that way. There is also drinking fountains found in that location. Also, a reminder that the Minnesota Zoo is a non-smoking facility, including the parking lot. Thank you for respecting this policy. If you took one of our shuttles to get to the amphitheater tonight, at the end of the ceremony, it will pick you up where it dropped you off. Also, we do have health and safety officers on site tonight to assist you should you need anything. And now, on with the ceremony.
Thank you. evening. You can have a seat. My name is Lauren Hastings, and I am so proud to be the principal of the School of Environmental Studies. I want to welcome everyone here tonight to celebrate the amazing class of 2024. You guys look awesome. Before we get started, I just have a few people that I want to thank. First of all, I want to just recognize how grateful I am to be here tonight at the Minnesota Zoo. Our partnership with the Minnesota Zoo shapes a lot of what we are able to do with students, and they do a lot of work for us all of the time, and especially to make tonight happen. So thank you very much to everyone from the Minnesota Zoo. There are some important people on the stage with me tonight that are incredibly supportive to SES and our students and our faculty and our families. And so I'd like to introduce them and thank them for coming. First, we have School Board Chairperson Corey Johnson. And we have School Board members Jackie Magnuson, Art Colson, and Sachin Isaacs. We also have our Director of Human Resources, Shelley Munson, and our Director of Secondary Education, soon to be the new superintendent, Michael Bolsoni. The reason that Michael is going to be the new superintendent is because Mary Krieger, our current superintendent, is retiring. And on behalf of all SES faculty and staff, Mary, thank you for your commitment to this district and for always supporting our little school. You will be missed. Thank you to everyone for being here to celebrate with us tonight. There are also some faculty members that I need to thank profusely for making this lovely night happen. First and foremost is Miss Molly Melton, who is currently handing a student water because that is the detail person she is. She is, in addition to being a fantastic greenhouse teacher, she also takes on the role of being the faculty advisor for our grad site council. So that means she is responsible for all of the details, from handing over water bottles to making sure these beautiful flowers are ordered, to ironing the tablecloth there, the programs, preparing our student speakers and singers, the whole shebang. Without her, this would not be what it is. So thank you, Molly, for all of the time and effort. Next, I have two men behind the sound and the streaming. So I have Mr. Dusty Miller and Mr. Cliff Dodge. They would like to hide over there in the corner, but along the lines of what I said about Miss Molly Melton, without their tech capabilities that I don't even come close to understanding, we would not have the sound or the ability for our loved ones who aren't here tonight to live stream it. So thank you so much for seeing to those details. The last person that I want to thank is Mr. Nathan Nelson. Mr. Nelson is the school counselor to senior students at SES. He also teaches AP Psych and Avid 12. He has spent a ton of time with the class of 2024, getting them ready for life after, well, today. He has worked at SES for 26 years, and he recently announced that he plans to retire at the end of this school year. So, Mr. Nelson, thank you for the unforgettable, immeasurable mark that you have left on SES and all of its countless graduates. So, best of luck in your next adventure. Thank you. Okay, I know that we want to get on with the ceremony, and we are going to do that. But first, class of 2024, I want to ask you to just take a moment. I want you to take a moment and look around at your classmates and friends that are sitting with you right now. Give them a little wave. Look for your people. Now, I want you to direct your gaze over to this row over here. Those are also your people, your teachers, that have been your cheerleaders, that have been there to support you and love you throughout your two-year journey at SES. And last but not least, of course, your family. Really, truly, go look around and find your family. Let them know that you see them here celebrating with you. They love you. They are so proud of you. So this night is going to go by quickly, but try to be in the moment and to enjoy celebrating all of us together. Okay, with that, we are going to get this thing started. I'm going to hand it over to two incredibly talented student MCs.
We would like to start with acknowledging the Dakota land we stand on. Their knowledge is an integral part of the SES curriculum.
Thank you, Carol Strecker and Ms. Hastings, for kicking things off tonight.
Thank you, Superintendent Krieger, for your careful guidance of District 196, and welcome to all our school board members. We want to give a special thank you to the faces behind the scenes that keep things running smoothly.
Thank you, Lisa, for always providing us students with breakfast, making those early mornings a little bit easier, and going the extra mile to give us a special lunch menu every day. And huge shout out to Sam Furpo, who has served as our school's building chief for 8 years. And we would like to welcome Brandon Werke as our new building chief.
And last but not least, thank you to each and every staff member for not only keeping our school running smoothly, but for making this a safe space for so many students. Let's give them all a round of applause.
Flip, flip. We'd also like to say thank you to all the people who helped get us to this point today. Our friends and family watching here in person or live streaming, your love and support outside of the classroom is crucial to our success.
Welcome to the graduation of 2024.
That was good. My name is Claren Berg.
And I'm Griffin Jones. We will be tonight's MCs.
Let's raise the roof for the graduating class of 2024.
Yes! Our journey here at SES was filled with memorable experiences and adventures that got us out of our comfort zones and changed our perspectives.
It all started when we were involuntarily put into rafts with new classmates at the start of junior year. We voyaged 2 miles down the Cannon River with only the company of our new friends.
We continued to grow closer with these new friends, eventually spending an overnight together at Baker Park, where we fostered our love for the cold weather, besides waking up in the middle of the night because someone forgot to feed the fire.
Anyways, spring brought warmer weather and energetic fourth graders, where we got the chance to be the teachers. Who knew teaching was that difficult?
We returned in the fall, gearing up for an amazing senior year. On day one, we were introduced to our new guide, the triple bottom line, which led us through biodiversity in Bidote, the population conference, infectious disease and toxicology, and finally our spring sustainable studies.
But we were forced to guide ourselves through the winter survival unit. But we all made it, I think. Should we do a quick head count?
It's fine, there's clearly enough graduates here today.
These 2 years have shaped all of us and given us countless memories we will carry with us into our futures. Speaking of memories, do you remember the talent show?
Yeah, there were so many great performances. You know what? Let's revisit some of those amazing acts tonight. To start us off, I'd like to welcome our school's one and only band, Copacetic, with Casey on guitar, Andy on rhythm guitar, Rosemary on bass, and Joaquin on drums. These talented individuals have came together for over a year now, bonding over the genre alt rock, creating 7 original songs together and an album in the works. Tonight they'll be performing a cover of the song Waiting by Green Day. Now let's welcome Copacetic to the stage.
right, give me a minute, guys. I actually, I'd like to thank all the teachers who've helped me along the way. Miss Yell, Mr. Melvin, Mr. Nowicki, Mr. Koenig, Mr. Forty, Miss Mountain, Mr. Colchin, Dusty, Miss Clements, Miss Pedersen, Mr. Autry. Thank you for putting up with me and helping me. And so this one's for you guys. Stars. I forgot to mention this, but Mr. Varley is also someone I really admire, and he's helped me a lot too, so thank you.
What an incredible performance from Copacetic. I have no doubt their talent and dedication will carry them far. I would now like to introduce our student speaker, Miguel Navarro. Miguel. Miguel has been incredibly dedicated to the SES community since his junior year. He spent time during the summer watering the SES community garden, and this year was Green Team President, which is a student-run organization devoted to keeping SES as sustainable as possible. He will continue his passion for nature and sustainability during college, planning to major in environmental science. His speech tonight is titled Courageous Leaps, Persevering Through Challenges. Let's welcome Miguel to the stage to share his message.
Congratulations to everyone here today. I want to say thank you to my parents and mi abuela for helping me on my journey and supporting me through everything. I also want to say thank you to my teachers and counselors for helping and motivating me during my hardest times. It seems like it was just a couple weeks ago, we were all just starting our story maps, research papers, population conferences, and the senior projects we all worked so hard on. Despite these stressful times, the reason we all stand here today is a result of our perseverance. At times, school felt really slow, and other times, it flew by quick. But during those times, we made long-lasting friendships, not only with our peers, but with our SES staff as well. Perseverance is something that I've been familiar with since I entered this world. When I was born, I aspirated meconium, and there was a high chance I wouldn't make it. I spent 14 days in the NICU fighting for my life, but I persevered, as you can see. Even after getting past my early health scare, growing up continued to be challenging. Statistically, the odds were stacked against me. I was born to teen parents living in poverty, sharing a room with my sister, mom, grandma, and great-grandma in a mobile home until the age of 4. I witnessed my parents overcome obstacle after obstacle, and to this day, they continue working hard to give us the best opportunities in life. Thanks to their example, I was able to endure the many hardships I went through, such as the challenges of growing up and the uncertainty of what's ahead, I seem very scared. That's just my story. Each one of you standing here today have your own story of challenges and doubt. When I first walked into SES, I was unknowingly accepting the many new challenges that I would soon face, and so were each of you. The alternating schedules we were all so unfamiliar with, the new curriculum that had us getting up from our seats and actively learning about environmental topics that were new to us. In all honesty, I struggled, and I don't think I was alone. During my first intensive theme week, Ms. CL invited me to join her AVID class. And during my time in AVID, I was introduced to Green Team, a group of students engaging with sustainability around SES campus. And I think for the first time, I finally felt like I was part of a community at our school. And it took me so long to realize that I was already part of something here at SES. Class of 2024 was a community from the start. We all came together to this new school for so many different reasons, whether it was to pursue environmental science, make new friends, or you just like the idea of an alternate schedule. What led us to this point was our openness to try something new and our perseverance to stick with it. It's what led me to join and eventually lead the SES Green Team. It's what led me to show up for the opportunity to represent our class today. Within our community, we worked hard, worked together, and made long-lasting friendships and memories we'll take with us on our next journey. When we, SES graduates, see new opportunities and challenges, taking the leap with confidence, courage, and valor is the only option we see. We know we have what it takes to accomplish anything we set out to do. Whatever path you decide to take, just remember that you will pull through, like our senior projects we all worked hard to accomplish. I believe we all persevere. Even on our worst days, we will all make it through. We all have the strength to accomplish anything we want, even in our moments where we feel hopeless. And it's okay to be uncertain of what to do from here on out. The constant stress of being expected to know which path to take or what to do with our lives is unnerving. The truth is, we're still kids. We have plenty of time to figure it out, make mistakes, take courageous leaps, and to find our purpose in life. And from what I learned in life is that things will work out. We all have the perseverance in us to take on whatever life throws at us. So let's take courageous leaps and enjoy what comes next in life.
Thank you, Miguel, for that empowering speech. Next, we have Britta Hagen and Kira Halligan singing for us this evening. I'd like to start off by talking about Britta. She's an outstanding graduate as she holds many talents and is the leader of the Faith Club here at SES. This fall, she'll be attending St. Olaf College, where she'll be showcasing her talent as a Division III volleyball player. Kira has also been an excellent student, effortlessly balancing her classes and music activities between Egan and SES. You may have seen her play one of the lead roles in Egan High School's production of Rock of Ages last fall. She's furthering her education at Northern Michigan University. These two talented individuals have shared a love for singing from an early age. Now let's welcome Britta and Kira to the stage as they will be singing For Good from the musical Wicked.
Thank you.
Well, we're going off script. Okay. How amazing was that duet? Alone, they are extraordinary singers, but together, they are even more wonderful. It is my privilege to present the last speaker of the night. I'm gonna restart on that. For the last speaker of the night, oh man. Okay, for our last speaker of the night, it is my privilege to present a teacher who needs little introduction. But as an MC, it's kind of in the job title. He has an undergraduate degree in genetics and a graduate degree in science education. He may have only worked at SES for 4 short years, but that has not stopped him from winning the hearts and minds of his students. He is more than just a teacher to many of us, taking an interest in our personal lives and showing us that educators and students can share hobbies and common interests. He is always there to support you, never directly giving you the answer, but instead a guiding hand and reassurance that you can do it. Everyone has come to enjoy his stories and endearing tangents that can instantly draw anyone's attention. Whether it be starting the beginning of class, looking at terrible physics jokes, or learning how he is sworn to secrecy by 3M, and yes, that's the sticky note company, there is never a dull moment in his class. He is most recognizable by his thought-provoking and mysterious magic can, his unmistakable coal-colored beard, and his distaste for Bill Nye the Science Guy. Well, I can plainly see that everybody is here. I know this teacher would also ask that you be here now. So please join me in welcoming Mr. Eric Colchin.
Hey, you guys. All right, I'm gonna put this away, Griffin. Try not to hide it from you. Hello and welcome. Thank you for inviting me to speak today. My name is Eric Colchin and I teach science at SES. In preparation for today's speech, I walked around in your pods to see if I could get the essence of the class of 2024. I learned a great deal. I learned that you care for each other, that you support each other, you take pride in your hard work, and most notably, you are weird. I walked around looking at your desks. I saw a taxidermied alligator head, a spring suspension for a car, a collection of hubcaps, because why not? Plants that are being astonishingly well taken care of right next to homework that is like a month late. I saw a very large collection of applesauce. Seriously, it was like 100 packages. I saw lots and lots of squishmallows, along with all kinds of other stuffed animals. I found a full-sized skeleton. That was yours? Okay, cool. It was dressed in formal wear. A picture of chicken nuggets that read, "Nugs, not drugs." Not sure if that's appropriate. Let's see. Legos and bobbleheads of many different Star Wars, anime, and Pokemon characters, all wonderfully weird. Your uniqueness brought you here to SES. Whether you realize it or not, it is not usual to leave your home high school after 2 years and start fresh with new students and teachers in a whole new building. And we are glad you came. This has been a place in which we welcome and embrace your uniqueness. In fact, probably the strongest evidence of your weirdness is that you nominated me to be your commencement speaker. We are unique here and we love it. I mean, how many times have you had a conversation with a friend or family member about the pond study or existentialism with Mr. Koenig or Ishmael or some other SES activity or lesson, and you realize that the best explanation was, you know what, it's just an SES thing? I mean, two words, cave prom. That was a good time. Let me show you something. Are you ready? Physics, forensics, are you ready? Yeah, that's weird. For those who don't know, in my class, I used this can to demonstrate about how we learn about science. You can make assumptions about what is in the can based on previous experiences, but you should change your thoughts once you see evidence that suggests differently. What we soon discover is this can does not behave normally. It builds curiosity and it forces us to question the assumptions we made to begin with. Like this can, your unique experiences and personalities are going to force the world to think differently. You're going to push boundaries and you're going to make us rethink what we assume is possible, and you are going to make the world better. Yeah. You're going to make the world better, and it's important that you do. The radically welcoming atmosphere at SES has made you open-minded, and it's given you a different perspective than most. It makes you care about the world we live in, and you want to make it better. I had an alumnus of SES tell me that he believes that even the location of SES tells people who visit that it's not business as usual here. We are set out, away, almost hidden. You have to really look to find it. And you did, you found it, and you jumped in. We accepted you and embraced your uniqueness, and you welcomed each other, and you created this community. And we are all better for it. Today, you venture off. Bring your weirdness with you, and the world will be better for it. Your experience makes you stand out with new ideas and creative ways to approach old problems. You have been forced to look at how you impact the world and how you should live in a sustainable world. The world needs your weird. Stay weird. Don't forget to, stay weird. Yeah, I like that. Don't forget to come back and tell us about your adventures. We love to hear from you. I leave you with some words of advice. Be nice. Be here now. And you are doing this. Thank you for your attention. And congratulations, class of 2024. We are super proud of you. And now, reading the names of the SES Class of 2024 graduates, it is my pleasure to introduce my colleagues and friends, Brian Johnson and Billy Koenig.
Waiting to keep your bean. It was in the way.
Clark Amid Marshall.
Sienna Arnold.
Tyrese Arnold. Carter Austin.
Claren Berg.
Claudia Berg.
Jackson Berkeley.
Mai Vidal Servant.
Elliot Binocta. Lucia Bintner.
Hampton Bishop. Bella Bocock. Colin Bolton.
Brooks Bowers. Carmen Braun.
Emily Breed.
Cody Bunnell.
Addison Burma.
Claire Burns. Dane Buxman.
Jaden Carlson.
Kayla Case. Karen Chauka Benavides. Kayla Christian.
Haley Cooper. Justin Cooper.
Gianna D'Angelo. Nevaeh Dalton.
Madeline Davis.
Lucia Diaz.
Kendall DeRico. Casey Dolan. Anna Dorson. Hannah Doobie.
Raina Dunn. Hayden Dilla. Mia Ekstrom. Chloe Edson. Elara Egner.
Zachary Ewing. Sarah Finlay. Hannah Fisher. Maxwell Floden.
Samantha Forseth.
Alexander Fox. Graham Galloway.
Ahana Garcia Rodriguez. Willem Garrity.
Evan Jenya.
Eileen Hennis Cook.
Clara Gilbert.
Catherine Gilbert. Samantha Gilliman.
Rosemary Godwin. Nicholas Gonzalo Mullinix. Joaquin Guerrero.
Kylie Harley.
Britta Hagen. Kira Halligan. Casey Hanger. Ian Hansen. Liam Hansen. Kieran Harvey.
Caden Hendrickson. Oliver Herod. Ace Hines. Dylan Hitz. Spencer Hoban. Ethan Howlater.
Zara Islam.
Alea Jacobson.
Jamie Jamison. Carrie Jaworski.
Owen Jane. Crow Johnson. Sophia Johnson.
Matthew Johnson. Griffin Jones.
Nora Casti. Marcy Katzenberger.
Giovanni Kennedy Glazer. Kayla King. Amelia Kennettle. Tatum Knight. Cammy Kraft.
Brandon Kraus.
Noah Kujawski.
Isabel Levon. Ingrid Lovell.
Dylan Lawrence. Kate Legg.
Soleil Len. Aiden Lesh. Robert Lyles IV. AJ Mains.
Bay Mayer. Gabriel Mangum. Elizabeth Medicheski. Andrew McBreen.
Peyton McCarthy.
Vesper McCoy.
Gibson McGrath.
Jackson McGregor. Dominic Mead.
Nicodemos Mokria. Alex Malucci.
Selena Marcel.
Charlie Meyer. Connor Miller.
Astro Mitchell. Elijah Montour. Grant Mollenbach. Owen Mergic. Miguel Navarro.
Victor Navarro Hernandez. Ruhama Nuguse. John Nold. Freya O'Loughlin. Emily Ocaranza Vasquez.
Esther Ocharo. Mallory Onstead. Cole Parker.
Anthony Perla Omana. Joshua Pinex. Yeah.
Andrew Prince. Madeline Ryland.
Noah Ritter.
Matthew Rodriguez.
Ian Rogers.
Isabella Rojas.
Casey Rossin. John Paul Sakta Espinoza. Abigail Schmidt.
Benjamin Schmidt.
Dylan Schoenfeld. Hannah Schwartz.
Avery Sirik. Gibson Snail. Katya Smith. Riley Smith. Matthew Snyder.
Isaac Sorensen. Aaron Sprouse.
William Sprunk.
Tyler Stack.
Eliana Stearns. Henry Strauss Klein. Abrielle Sutton.
Izzy Terrell. Ruby Thorpe. Abigail Tabebe.
Grayson Tix. Maureen Tutong.
Layla Tresseter.
Thank you. Steven Vanderpoel.
Joey Voss. Mackenzie Wahlberg. Kylie Wells. Kiera Wiese.
Aiden Whitaker. Elizabeth Whitney. Abigail Willie Borchard.
Kendra Wood.
Yusra Youssef. Ella Zeal de Cruz.
I need you to stand up now, because it is my distinct honor to officially present to everyone the graduated class of School Environmental Studies, class of 2024. Congratulations.